Hello, everyone. Hate starting the show off on a sad note, especially when it's somebody that I know who passes away. And I remember this young man, my previous job here in Yeehaw, Texas. Great young man, hardworking young man, a family man, just had a baby 2 months ago. And unbelievable, while he was on vacation in Idaho, where he's from originally, passed away, drowned, swimming, just a heartbreaking loss, married for 3 years. My buddy Dallin Hill. Dallin Hill, D-A-L-L-O-N, Hill, H-I-L-L. Only 23 years old, born April 22nd, 1996. Sadly, tragically passed away at the age of 23, August 10th, 2019. No drugs, nothing like that. Did something a lot of people do, you know. A lot of friends will jump off a bridge, diving, you know. Nothing major, wasn't a high one or anything like that. Unfortunately, he never came back up. Growing up as a kid, bridges back home, my brother and our friends dove off them all the time. I didn't because I'm a horrible swimmer. This is a sad loss, a tragic loss of a great young man, a hardworking man, a great family man. Just had a baby 2 months ago. And folks, it breaks my heart. It really does to see another great young man pass away much too young. Folks, a moment of silence, please, for my dear friend, Dallin Hill, and thoughts and prayers to him and his family, And wow, just shocking, absolutely shocking. Dallin, rest in peace, my friend. All right, well, you know we can't have the show on a sad note. That's not how we do business. And let's get this life started. Let's get this party started, you know. We're all going to go someday. I don't plan on going anywhere for a while. Maybe my voice, the way things are going, but I don't know. Let's do this and do it. Right. Hello, everyone. It is indeed Thursday.
I'm going to tell you about my
August
days when my health was good, but my mind was
crazy. In the year of our Lord, 2019. How are all you doing out there?
Yes, I got
it. How are you doing, awesome, as always?
True,
working awesome.
Going to relate
hey,
to you. We'll keep
tomorrow's
you
Friday,
like
Friday. Yeah.
Insane.
Because you know beer is good for you. You have to keep talking there right now. And folks, no time like the present to get our drink on, right? Got that right. And it's the boss man, so I stand in the cheerio box. I'm putting on my first beer. Folks, I'm warning you now. There's going to be a lot of bear movies on this show. There's going to be a lot of great music. Some songs are risky to play because they may be muted. So if there's any parts of this show that get muted, you've already been warned as to why. Our first beer of the day is Westy Barrel Brewing Company out of Mifflinburg, Pennsylvania. Fool's Gold Imperial Peanut Butter Hefeweizen. Adam Allegrucci, the badass beer of the Italian division from Pennsylvania. Brother, this one's for you, Val. And, sorry, I'm writing right now.
I'm just trying to make a point and make
it. Adam Allegretti, Justin Smith, angry, the badass bearded beast I know from Pepper's Hill Brewing Company, part of something you never get on. You guys are awesome. No beer, and Adam, this one's coming to you now on Saturday. Probably on grass, but that needs you to go.
Beer is good for you. Beer is good for you. Beer is good for you.
Yeah.
Beer is good for you.
45 degree ready to be a substitute fast driver. Keep
Dr.
on. Cause I'm just that damn good. I'm just going to drop the other hand.
Oh, baby, that beer is good for you. Give your tongue a tingle and your mind a buzz. And wake up in the morning with a mouthful of fuzz. Oh, baby, that beer is good
for you. Ah, yeah.
Cheers, beer for all you crossing. Give me 5 cents, man. Give me that picture of this beer real quick.
Beer is good for you. Not as good as sex, but it's better than jail.
Yeah.
So tell the man behind the bar, B-E-E-R, I'm telling you beer is good for you. And you know beer is good for you.
That's a good picture.
Beer is good for you.
This is true.
Beer is good for you. Beer is good for you.
Beer is good for you.
Beer is good for you.
Beer is all you brought, St. Jimmy Pison.
The peanut butter is definitely there. The smoothness of bananas is definitely there. You know, think about the Elvis Presley sandwich. You know, he had peanut butter, bananas. Yeah. In fact, our dear friends at Toasted Traveler Food Truck made one. Awesome stuff. All right. Let me bring out our next song. Let's see here. I'm just checking real quick. Wifey messaged me. Let's bring out the next song. Beer Bottle Boogie. Rufus Thomas with Bobby Plater's Orchestra. 1950. Oh, yeah. Here we go. Before I get to the birthday shoutouts, I have got to discuss something real quick that I just found out today. For my dear friend Ron Poston, Amber Dragon Meadery. That's not his label, but I have something to have his label.
One night I was feeling higher than a kite. My poor old heart
is Amber Dragon Meadery. Yes, soon to become a reality, folks.
Got in the
this one's Broken Mary. I'm not drinking this one because it's warm and I like it cold. But Amber Dragon Meadery, Viking Mushrooms, Ron Poston, Lorraine Aston, his lovely guy's better half, Insane White, my flat top brother. They're a trifecta of exquisite wicked awesomeness. Well, they've been giving out a lot of free samples of mushrooms in need for quite a while. Well, some inbred twisted fuck out there decides they want to try to get Ron in trouble. What the fuck is the point of trying to bust somebody for handing out free stuff? What are you, fucking stupid? Who the fuck is the rat out there that needs to be whacked? Who? I'm telling you. First of all, Ron Poston. Ron Poston, Lorraine Aston, Zane Weber, Flacco Brother. I love you, three of you so much. And I'm pretty sure I'm going to make a lot of salute to you. Yeah. Because you're wicked awesome. But I cannot believe that somebody is trying to bring you down, Ron. Don't get up. What the fuck? What the hell the fuck is going on around here? Some piss-ant fuck face. What, are they worried that their business is going to be hurt because you're going into business? I don't know who it is, but God help you if I find out. Well, no, I'm going to whack you. I'm not going to do that. But I'll tell you, I'll sever all ties with you. I don't surround myself with negativity like that. Fuck that. So, Ron, and you're on. I'm going to drink some of your beer tonight. You gave me a long time ago. 45 to bed, ready to meet. Some shit up on the fire to keep on. I'm going to start damn good. I'm going to drop you in the middle. I know damn well it wouldn't be anybody who's part of the Happy Soul Brewing Company. Nobody would do that.
He said, get out of here, boy. You ain't got
everybody's always appreciative. And if anybody has any issue with him handing out me, they would tell him. Be like, yo, dude. Sorry, every time my wife texts, she loves to text. So, I hate texting, but she loves it. So, yep, she'll be home pretty soon. All right. So, yeah, cheers to me, to all of you. Protestant in Germany, Combined State in Japan. Again, thank you so much, Ron. And Ron, hey, you can always hit me up, man. Right now I'm good. I've got 4 bottles of mead. But if you end up making anything that I want some of, I'll message you private. Because, brother, we've got to trust. You know, I love you like a brother. We are fellow brethren. And I would never, ever, ever do that to you or anyone else. Because that is as fucked up as a football bat. And people like that deserve to die a slow, miserable, painful death. Because they're obviously somebody who's all about themselves. Greedy. Doesn't give a shit. Trying to ruin a good thing. You know, people like that just, they just need a get the Jeffrey Dahmer treatment. That's what they need to get. Fuck yeah. So yeah, let's drink. I don't even remember which one this one is, but oh my God. I don't remember which one this one is, Ron. Oh, I think it's rum raisin. I think this one's rum raisin, actually, now that I can taste it. Let me take another sip real quick. And I think that rum raisin, didn't it sit around 20%? I can't remember. Whew. I think that's the rum raisin, actually. And, yeah, awesome stuff. All right. This one goes out to you, Jeff Bell. Power Struggle Brewing Company, 409 South Trader Union, Abilene. Yeah, Texas. And this also goes out to my good friend, Teddy Gray. Teddy Gray, the pride of the 559, an epic badass hard-working man with Gemini I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma, pretty much the same damn state. Teddy, my man, you wanted to hear some Stevie Ray Vaughan. It's always a guarantee that Jeff Bell of Happy Sugar Brewing Company is going to get some Stevie Ray Vaughan. Because Jeff, I love you like a brother, and we're fellow brethren as well. And me, you, and Ron, hell yeah, brother. I suck. And Teddy's not a fellow Masonic member of 559, but he rides the 559, and Teddy knows what I'm, he's picking up what I'm putting down. So yeah, all right, here we go. Cold Shot, Stevie Ray Vaughan, January 1984. Oh, what a song this is. Yeah. We all have birthday shoutouts to give. We got additional shoutouts to give. All kinds of good stuff. We got some serious eye candy. So yeah. Let's have a sip. I already know I'm not gonna be sober by the end of this show. Every time I unleash the beat, it's never a good outcome. It never is. Alright, happy birthday to my good friend Jen Lynch's. Jennifer Lynch's. Her and her superstar husband Bill, I've known for almost 8 years now. They're the curators of the 12 Diamond Division Museum, 1289 North 2nd Street here in Abilene, Yeehaw, Texas. And if you've never been there, please do me a favor and go. They worked so hard to keep my grandfather's legacy, along with many other veterans of World War II, 12th Army Division. My grandfather's 12th Army Division, World War II, U.S. Army, of course, 17th Armored Infantry Division, part of George Patton's Mystery Division, after the Battle of Hurlesheim. My grandfather, Bronstein, Purple Heart recipient, and a proud member of 12th Army. I'm a proud legacy member of 12th Army Division. And Jen, you, my dear friend, do so much. You and Bill, I love you guys. And I officiated the wedding ceremony on 12-12-12 at the 12th, started at 12 p.m., ended at 12-12 p.m. in 12 seconds. It was awesome. And they are doing wicked awesome. Jennifer Lynch's, happy birthday to you, my wicked awesome friend. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Love and well. And enjoy. Good old bird turns on birds to you, my dear. And Bill, have some beef three oatmeal stout. Yeah. I want to give a shout out to my man, John Peterson. John Peterson, welcome to the house. Big time blues aficionado. I work down here in Yeehaw, Texas. All I know is West Louisiana. Hey, living in Tennessee. All I know is Southern Kentucky. Originally from Alabama. All I know is Eastern Mississippi. That's right. John and his lovely guys, Ben and Rebecca. Incredible couple. Incredible parents. An incredible friend of mine. And John knows his blues the way I know them. My goal every week is to find something new that he's never heard. Hopefully I can do that this weekend, John. I know I got John one. I already know there's gonna be one of them, John. Because I wasn't even familiar with it. I forgot I had it. You'll love it when you hear it. That's coming on later on in the show. But big cheers, busy here, John. Hell yeah. All right. Happy birthday to my good friend,
Bruce Gappa. Bruce Gappa, a legend I know from inside Japan. He's an outstanding man. And he's doing great things. If I'm not mistaken, working in Japan today, it's been a long time since I heard from Bruce. Living up in Minnesota,
it looks like. Nice.
Got your own business.
You're a sheet metal structural maintenance. And awesome guy. No doubt about it, Bruce Gappa. Happy birthday to you, bud. Hope you're doing well. Hope you're living it up. And I hope you have a wicked awesome day. And brother, celebrate well and enjoy. And a big cheers and bears to you, Bruce. Alright. Our next song is the Tedeschi Trucks Band. This is, I think it's Derek Trucks, if I'm not mistaken. Him and Susan Tedeschi. Susan Tedeschi, I knew the name sounded familiar. I've been familiar with Susan Tedeschi for over 2 decades. And I did some more reading up on her today. Oh, she's a Massachusetts native. Born in Boston. Grew up in Norwell, Massachusetts. But I did not know that her great-grandfather is famous for all the Tedeschi food shops that are in Massachusetts and the surrounding area. Unfortunately, I did hear that they were bought out by 7-Eleven in 2015, and eventually everything's going to change from Tedeschi to 7-Eleven. Freaking heartbreaking, these damn corporations. I wish they would just keep the name Tedeschi. T-E-D-E-S-C-H-I. Well, Susan Tedeschi is phenomenal. And her husband, Derek, is phenomenal, too. Tedeschi Trucks Band, requested by my good buddy, Chris Thompson, a beer-brewing badass living down here in Yeehaw, Texas. And I worked with him in Exotic Japan. He's an outstanding man. And he delivers awesomeness every day out in San Antonio. Yep, that's right. He does what you do, Teddy Gray. Yeah, buddy. How about that? Awesome stuff. Ain't been too awesome this summer. It's been wicked hot, huh? Not like beer, sweating your Royal Rastafari and ninis off and having no damn air conditioning. Jesus. How the hell you guys do it, but God bless you. So Made Up Mind, Tedeschi Trucks Band, 2013. A great song. I think you'll agree. Here you go. Uh-oh. What? Oh, great. Really? Is it going to do that shit to me now? I may have to use the other player, which takes 15 seconds every time it tries to play. Son of a bitch. I guess so. Son of a bitch, I'm going to have to use the other player. Fuck! I hate this player because it's fucking slow. God! Here we go. Waiting. And if this doesn't work, then I'm fucked. F-U-K apostrophe D, fucked. I don't have the song. I just downloaded it today and converted a, come on. Is it not going to play? Jesus. Power Media Player sucks. That's all I know. Should automatically play. Come on. I guess it's not going to play. Oh, here we go. I think. I don't know. It's got the circle of death. Son of a bitch! This is why I hate this player. Power Media Player licks goat nuts, okay? It does. It's not going to play. I'm going to have to grab it from you. I'm going to have to play it from YouTube. It's not going to play. Fuck me. Alright. Ah, fuck me running. 2 text messages. All right, well, so, We're going to have to do it this way. Bear with me, folks. I apologize. Lord, I apologize. Son of a bitch. Rah! Fuck! Such a freaking pain in the ass. Made up mind. And of course, it's probably going to go to a commercial first. That's as loud as I can have my phone, so I apologize for that, okay? Yeah. Alright, well, while we're doing this, I want to say happy birthday to my good friend Cassie Zafoli. Cassie Zafoli is a wonderful, wicked, awesome, sweetheart of a lady that I know from Giant England. And yeah, Texas. So, yep, there you go. Looks like I'm probably going to have to play, Blue on Black by Kenny Wayne Shepherd from YouTube as well. Because unfortunately, I had a request for Kenny Wayne Shepherd by both Tom Bradley, the best damn beer pal in Abilene, Texas, and Ted Caffey mentioned him too. So yeah, good tune. Cassie's a Foley, I apologize. Happy birthday to you, my dear friend. I worked with her wicked awesome husband, Tony. Tony's the Foley. Worked with them in Joyland, England. And they were living in here in Yale, Texas for a while. Now they moved again. Already. They're like nomads. Telling you. And Cassie got a baby on the way. Congratulations, Cassie and Tony. Hell yeah. And a wicked awesome mom, Deborah, so excited for her. My grandmother again, aw yeah. Deborah Zafoli, Tony's mom, a wicked awesome lady. Love the Zafoli family. And Cassie, always keep it classy. Happy birthday to you, my dear friend. Hope you're living it up. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Summer well and enjoy. I'm gonna go hardcore for you. Cheers and mead. Cheers and beers, too. Yeah. Oh, I got a made up mind. Always meet up on the all right. Time. Happy birthday to my good friend, Regina Ole. Regina Ole. I met her online here years ago on Facebook. And I don't even remember how we met. But by God, we kept in touch. Regina's out of Zamboanga, Philippines. A wonderful sweetheart of lady, Regina, happy birthday to you. Of course, now it's August 16th as I'm doing my show. But I hope you had a good day. I hope you had a wicked awesome day. I wouldn't expect anything less from you. So tell me later tonight, I'm doing a bit of awesome stuff from you. Hey, tell me while I'm enjoying a bird, cheers a bird to you. Happy birthday to a dear friend of mine I've known for over 37 years. Knew her growing up as Julie Rogers. That would be Julie Gales. And there you go. All right. Give me a moment before we get to the next song. Julie Gales. A wonderful, wicked, awesome, sweetheart friend of mine. Final state graduate of Master Physics High School class in 1989. And, the lovely Julie, her and her sister Amy, and my brother and I all went to Finham First Baptist Church together. We were all in the junior choir together. And Julie, happy birthday to you, my wonderful friend. I hope you're doing marvelous. Great hearing from you. It's always awesome hearing from you. a wonderful, wicked, awesome sweetheart of a lady, a wicked, awesome mommy, a wicked, awesome friend, comes from a wicked, awesome family. And Julie Gales, happy birthday to you. Hope you have a wicked, awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy, and I'll bird cheers and beers to you. I, Tom Bradley, a beer brewing badass, a gold, multiple gold medal winning beer brewer, home brewer, one of the legends of the Home Brewers Association here in Abilene, Texas. Tom Bradley, a very dear friend of mine, a great leader of men, women, and it's you, my friend, you wanted to hear some Kenny Wayne Shepherd. And I agree. Kenny Wayne Shepherd needs to be heard. Travis Eason of Pappy Soda Brewing Company. I meant to acknowledge you. You mentioned Tedeschi Trucks Band about a month ago. Travis Eason played Tedeschi Trucks Band in Chris Thompson's honor and also in your honor. He works over at Pappy Soda. He's also a professional tattoo and fine art legend. TravisEason.com. He's been a phenomenal tattoo legend for many, many years. You need a tattoo, this is the guy to go to. I'm telling you right now. I've seen his work, and it is absolutely wicked awesome. It's Méchant Genie. French for wicked awesome. You know what I'm saying, eh? That's what I'm talking about. Ho, Canada indeed. Hey, got your little names up north, and I do it on Bears on every single day of the week. Figgin' eh? So yeah, there you go. All right. Now this song is supposedly not safe to be played on Facebook. It didn't say blocked in a certain amount of countries. It just said could be muted. So here we go. Blue on Black, Kenny Wayne Shepherd. This song is from 1997. Kenny Wayne Shepherd, I remember seeing him when he was young. In Lancaster, California, many, many years ago. Kenny Wayne Shepherd was influenced by the legendary late, great Stevie Ray Vaughan. Look at that, Marshall Tucker Band came to see. Well, we hear that one at Pappy Soda Brewing Company all the time. Hi, Travis. Hi, Jeff. Love that song. Love that song very, very much. Not going to play it today, but... Man, Midnight in Harlem, another great Tedeschi Trucks Band song. All right. Let me give a shout out to my man, Mike Falkenstein, real quick. Mike Falkenstein is a big supporter of Beer Story Day, always sharing my live shows. So it's important that I give him a shout out on here. Mike, you freaking rock. You're wicked awesome. I know you're gonna give me a, I know you're gonna share my show, so I'm gonna give you a cinnamon to love back to sleep. Oh, hell yeah, brother. And we're gonna give you some cowbell. Yeah. Great video right here. Great song, Blue on Black. Yeah. Well, hey, Ron Poston, somebody might be back to Black and Blue eventually, huh? Because Ron Poston, you know, some people need to be beaten with a bag of hammers. I'm just saying. I don't push for violence, but I certainly am not against it. Okay? Yeah. Sometimes people just need to be beaten. It happens. I'll bring some need to that. Happy birthday to a longtime friend of mine on the Mafia Watch, Richard Reed. Richard, I haven't heard from you in a long, long time. I miss the days of Mafia Watch. It was a lot of fun. Great times. We're all whacking the hell out of each other and then end up having running families. It was great. I was part of the best day of Mafia Watch family ever. Straight Fight United with Team Artillery does make the dream work. And Richard Reed, awesome guy. Love to hear from you. Happy birthday to you. Hope you're doing well, and I hope you have a winter awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy, and I'll very cheers of beer to you, buddy. Oh, listen to that, will ya?
How about a good old Wichita Falls, Texas shout out to our former real David and Dave on Beer and Sauna Day. The lovely, amazing, ageless wonder, Margie Ann. I met you through a guy a long time ago. And although I saw you guys do a one together, Simon, you and I are friends for life, because that we are. Margie, you're a total sweetheart. You absolutely rock. And I miss the hell out of you. And happy birthday to you, Margie Ann. And I hope you ever wake up today. You live it up, girl. Celebrate well and enjoy. And I'll big cheers and beer to you, my dear friend. All right, where are we at on this song here?
We got another minute before this song's over. So I want to go ahead and give a big Oklahoma happy birthday shout out to my dear friend, Brooke Lillard. Brooke Lillard, a wonderful Wicked Awesome sweetheart of a lady, a Wicked Awesome mommy, a Wicked Awesome friend who enjoys life, always enjoying life. I love your post. Your post are always cool, classy, funny. And I love the fact that you've got the guts to tell it like it is. Brooke, we need more people like you in the world. I would say be fruitful and multiply, have a litter of kids. But you've already got a good amount of kids. You've already made the world a better place. And now your children are doing the same. Because awesome parents make awesome babies. And those babies make awesome babies too. Brooke Lillard, happy birthday to you, my mama's friend. I hope you're living it up. I hope you're having fun. I hope you're getting spoiled rotten. I wouldn't expect anything less from you. Hey, you celebrate well and enjoy. And because you're so strong and so awesome, I'm going to slam the rest of this here mead down the drain in your honor. Down the pipe.
Does your battery deliver extra light?
Yeah. Eat a dick. Not you. Jeez. Freaking bone schmucks.
Empty as a break, tells of an average.
What your Canadian fan, eh? You know what I'm saying, eh? So I'm talking about
you. Oh!
Canada indeed. Again, always gotta give love to the neighbors up north, because I do it on Bears on every single day of the week. There you go.
Alright!
I'm gonna try to stay away from the mead, because if I keep drinking mead, I'm gonna die. And you don't wanna see me die on my show, right? Some of you probably wanna see me puke on my show, but. You people are mean, damn it. Alright. So, we need to go ahead and bring out our next song. And this was requested by my good friend, Kevin Harding. Kevin Harding is a phenomenal leader of men and women. It's a badass icon, badass cool dog. Works with Angelo in England. He's an Arizona legend. He's living in Arizona, otherwise known as, that's right, Western New Mexico. Pretty much the same damn state. And Kevin Harding, my friend, you are a walking brain of a man. You and I have so much knowledge about so many things in life, and I love it. It's always a pleasure talking to you. You're such a great man, a great family man, a great dad, a great friend, a great husband. Kevin, you fucking rock, dude. And you requested it. You got it. Robert Johnson. That's right. King of the Delta Blues, Robert Johnson. And this is take one. Love in Vain, recorded during his last recording session, Dallas, Texas, June 20th, 1937. And ironically enough, by the time you watch the show, it will have been 81 years to the day before he died. He tragically passed away August 16th, 1938, under mysterious circumstances. They say he was poisoned by a jealous lover. And I believe that. I believe it. Somebody else out there, the old saying is that he made a deal with the devil, which is why he played guitar so well. Made a deal at the crossroads. Well, you know, if he did, and the devil took him young, I got nothing on that. But Robert Johnson, an absolute icon, born May 27th, 1911, tragically passed away at the age of 27, just like a lot of the great rock and roll legends and stuff like that have done that as well. Love in Vain, June 20th, 1937. Take one. Recorded in Dallas, Texas. Here you go. For you, Kevin Harding. We're already 35 and a half minutes into the show. I got a long way to go. I'm doing 20 songs today. Okay? Well, 22 in total. I'm on song number 6. I want to say happy birthday to my good friend, Jolyn. Or Jolene. J-O-L-Y-N. Leonard. Jolene Leonard. I always pronounce Jolene, Jolyn. Jolene. Probably Jolene. J-O-L-Y-N. I hope I'm pronouncing it right. You tell me how it's pronounced, it, Jolene. Jolene Leonard, a wonderful, wicked, awesome, sweet Ivy lady, a longtime friend of mine on the Mafia Wars, and we've definitely kept in touch. Jolene, amazing, amazing lady, and boy, we love our apps on your Facebook. Great times, especially Mafia Wars, but we've remained friends through all these years. And Jolene Leonard, happy birthday to you, my friend. I hope you're having fun. I hope you're living it up. I hope you have a wicked awesome day. And girl, you celebrate well and enjoy it. Bird chose her mercy. I love this song. I'm going to turn it up a little bit because this song's a little bit quieter. Let's say happy birthday to my man Richie Yost. Yo, Richie! Rich Yost, a bubble-chasing badass icon that I worked with in Exotic Japan, an outstanding man, a great leader of men, women, and it's an Arizona guy, and a license plate collector like me. Rare, but we're out there. Albuquerque, baby. Automobile License Plate Collector Association, been around since 1954. And Rich and I are members, we're proud members, and I haven't been active in buying license plates. I'm going to get back into it. I've got to get my 1973 birth year run complete for all the United States and Canada. My license plate collection goes back to 1911. So Rich Yost, phenomenal guy, a great man, a great Christian man. And a very dear friend of mine. And yo, Richie! Missed the hell out of you, buddy. Haven't heard from you in a little while, so drop me a line. Let me know how you're doing. I'll probably hear from you today. You probably already commented. Miss you big time, bud. Cheers and beers to you, or whatever you're drinking. A big cheers to you, my friend. Miss you so much. Good times in Exotic Japan. Our next song takes us to 1995, and Jeff Bell of Pappy Soccer Brewing Company. I know how much you love Joe Satriani. We're going to play some Joe Satriani, and I know our good buddy Travis Eason likes some Joe Satriani, too. How about you there, Brian Kokenauer? Brian Kokenauer, Brian, a.k.a. Coke. Coke is another one of the owners of Pappy Soccer Brewing Company in Florida. I saw Treadway here in Abilene. And I want to go ahead and give Coke, I want you, because you're like me, Coke. We like them a little thicker, don't we? That's right. Because, hey, we're not dogs. We don't eat bones. But, hey, we'd give her a bone of our own if we were single, right? You got that right. Her name is Ruby May. Ruby May. She was born in England. I'm sorry, born in Australia, raised in England. And moved back to Australia when she was 18 years old. So she's an English Aussie hottie. And she has no problem showing her big jugs. Those are natural bazoombas. She's 5'1", 136 pounds. Man, I tell you right now, she is hot. And I tell you, folks, I'm warning you. This show is gonna get bad. Oh, clavage. French for cleavage. Tu es très jolie. That's French for saying you are very pretty, and that she is. So yes, Brian Kokenauer, now that I have your attention. Yo, Richie! Richie Wagner. I also mentioned him too. There's three owners of Pappy Sucking Brewing Company, and that's Jeff Bell, Brian Kokenauer, and Rich Wagoner. Those three guys are the trifecta of exquisite, wicked awesomeness that run that incredibly wicked awesome brewery. I'm telling you, folks, you need to be there this Saturday, because this Saturday, from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m., our dear friends, Matt and Becky Jackson, and Boo, hopefully Randy too, and their staff, the Bow Thai Food Truck, that's right, Thai food, honoring Thai food with family and friends, sharing Thai food with family and friends. Oh, I'm telling you folks, these guys are incredible. Everybody loves them. Anybody who doesn't like Bow Thai is stuck on stupid, okay? I'm serious about that. You gotta be stuck on stupid. That stuff's so freaking amazing. And hey, if you're a vegan or a vegetarian, that's the place to be. Bow Thai, because they've got vegan and vegetarian dishes. And you know, some people have to have that lifestyle to keep themselves alive. So, I myself am a proud omnivore. I'll eat whatever the fuck I want, whenever I want, as much as I want. That's me, baby. But not everybody is that lucky, unfortunately. So yeah, all right. So, did I rant enough about Pappy Slocum and Bow Thai? Nah, I never give them enough love. I always try, but you requested this one, Ted Cathy. Ted Cathy, who is a very loyal customer at Pappy Slocum Brewing Company, 409 South Trade right here in Abilene, yeah, Texas. And he also, being that he lives in Clyde, Texas, he's also hooked up with my good friends Carl and Amanda Price out at Primal Brewing Company out in Baird, Texas. Very dear friends of mine. They came to Pappy's to... Carl came to Pappy's to meet me in person. He found me online. Came to Pappy's Slocum on June 22nd. Met me in person. And I'm telling you right now, this guy, he's got a great thing going. Now, granted, not everybody loves his beers. I do, because I have a treat for sweets. His beers are generally lean to the sweeter side. That's been said. But you know what? He just opened May 17th. The beers are going to get better. Believe me, the beers are always getting better at Pappy Slocum. They're amazing. And they're going to keep getting better and better and better and better and better. Mo' better. Yeah. All right. Ted Cathy, you requested some Slim Harpo. I've played this song in the past on YouTube and on Facebook and never had a problem. Even though it says it could be muted. Hopefully it doesn't get muted today. Shake Your Hips, February 1966, Slim Harpo. I love me some Slim Harpo. This guy is amazing. Listen to that mouth harp too. Oh yeah, let's drink the rest of this beer real quick.
I wanna tell you about a dance.
FCS are great sounds in that Los Angeles Lakers fan.
Back to the Boston Red Sox fan zone, chicken box. Keep my beers freaking cold. And here's a beer that I featured live on an unofficial show yesterday, but I have never featured on an official edition of Beers on Today.
From Tree Ring Brewing Company out of Asheville, North Carolina. High Wire, low pitch, juicy IPA. Take drives down. Another way that works over at Pappy Slocum Brewing Company at 409 South Trade Way. Tate is always great. Tate, I had this beer yesterday. It is very juicy. It is awesome. I love it. I only have one left. If you want it, let me know. Though. Tell me you took the time to watch my show. You take the time to watch my show. You're going to get this here free beer. Okay, Tate Drysdale. Yes, sir. Yeah!
Probably your best puff technique.
In a country town, she says, why do you know? There's some pop.
Oh, by the way, Jeff Bell, that's a 12-ounce beer consumption apparatus. Yeah, it's just, I'm just emulating.
planning on a discussion we had a while back. It's obvious that this is a 12-ounce beer because I'm Zach Brassa. You just watch what I did. But yeah.
Shake your hips, baby!
Our baby today's got hips that she can shake. Fuck yeah. Oh yeah! God, I love that song. That's for you, Ted Kathy. Ted Kathy, an iconic, epic, badass Mammy Jammer who's given me so many gifts over the years. The man makes some incredible food. He's a wicked, awesome guy out in the great town of Clyde, Texas. Clyde, America. Home of my good buddy Jeff Bell. Home of my good buddy Ted Kathy. Home of my dear friends Justin and Carmen Kumaga. And home of my dear friend and the mayor of Clyde himself, the legendary Roger Brown, the pride of the 683, baby. Oh, yeah. Hi. I want you to listen to the lyrics closely on this next one, because this song is called Trucking Little Woman. From March 30th, 1938, he is my favorite pre-war bluesman. Pre-war, that's pre-World War II, in case you were wondering. Big Bill Brunzy. I am such a huge fan of Big Bill Brunzy. Love this guy. And Trucking Little Woman, March 30th, 1938. And listen to the trumpet by Punch Miller on this one. Oh, man. This song is great. I love it. This song was recorded on March 30th. Kevin Harding was born on March 30th. I won't mention the year unless you don't care. My dear daughter Delilah was born March 30th, 2002. 64 years to the day after this song was recorded. So here we go, Trucking Little Woman.
Hey, Bill Brunzy, March 30th, 1938. Charge the bells to all you prostrate journey by stage man.
Children, if I'm not mistaken. Well, maybe it was 17. I think it was 22, though. I think it was one of 22 children. He had a half-brother known as Washboard Sam. Washboard Sam was a phenomenal washboard player. Probably the best damn washboard player ever. You know, back in the 30s, you know, back in the day, you used washboard to wash laundry, of course. Well, Washboard Sam turned it into a musical instrument, and the rest is history. In fact, I think it was actually others, even before Washboard Sam, who were playing washboards. But Washboard Sam was probably the best washboard player ever. And his half-brother, Big Bill Brunzy, is on guitar in this one. I was just reading this earlier today. This one's called Jumpin' Rooster. June 16th, 1938. Washboard Sam. I think you're going to like this one. Pay attention to that percussion, that washboard. You already hear it.
I want to send everybody to my bed.
Take the tank off the tank, Meyer.
Tank is a bubble chasing badass icon. I worked with a German in England. He's a great man, a great family man, an Oklahoma native, an Oklahoma resident. And him and I went to Bible camp 8 years ago.
Remember that tank? Oh, yeah.
We found God. We learned lots of scripture. We learned a lot about adult beverages too, didn't we? And Tank.
Well, Tank has still made a milestone birthday. And Tank is a gentle giant. Tank is one of the nicest guys I've ever met in my entire life. As long as you didn't meet Hank or Frank, you were good to go, right, Tank? Yeah. Oh, Tank. I love you, bro. I miss the hell out of you. Happy milestone birthday to you, big guy. And you're a legend here in Yeehaw, Texas, too. And we all know Texas is just Southern Oklahoma anyway. They loved you here in Abilene, Texas. And they loved you in Charlotte, England. And we all love you, Ted. Happy milestone birthday, buddy. And a big cheers and beers, and I hope you celebrate your style.
Final birthday shout-out for today goes to my dear friend, Mary Dode.
K-N-O-D-E, Marianne.
Marianne Dode. Mary, a legendary leader of the women's heads. Come on, I was a water brand lady. Then I worked with a Dodge band. She's an outstanding role man.
Her husband, Vance, is absolutely wicked awesome as well. And you guys are amazing. I'm a Hawaii baby. Yeah, we love Hawaii. And
Mary, a quiet, peaceful, spiritual, wonderful friend. Mary, dude, happy birthday to you, my friend. I hope you're living it up. I hope you're having fun, and I hope you're having an awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Little bird, chicken bird, see my dear.
Wake up and find you dead. 7:15 here in Yeehaw, Texas. The sun's starting to set already. Damn it. Alright. We've gone through all the August 15th birthdays. I've got a few August 16th birthdays I've got to mention. And I gotta double check. Oh, I'm glad I double checked my notes because our next song. Hopefully, I know I've played this song on YouTube before. So I never had a problem with it. The song was recorded June 1969 and released in December 1969. It's one of the most famous blues songs of all time by one of the most famous bluesmen of all time, Riley King, better known as Blues Boy. That's what the BB stands for. Riley Blues Boy King was born September 16th, 1925. Passed away at the ripe old age of 89 years old early in 2015. And we miss him. We love him. His most famous song ever, The Thrill Is Gone. You requested it there, Joel Timmons. Joel Timmons, a very dear friend of mine that we have been friends on Facebook for many years. He found me through my Beer and Song of the Day page. You see the Beer and Song of the Day aluminum heart over there. Okay? He found me on my Beer and Song of the Day page. And I had him as a friend on Facebook, and we keep in touch all the time. Joel Timmons
is such a freaking incredible guy, and I hope to God I get to meet you in person someday. I really do. All my friends that I have on Facebook that I haven't met in person yet, I want you to know I would love to meet you all in person. Because you folks are so inspirational. You're so cool. I don't add any Joe Schmuck or whatever on Facebook. You gotta be cool before I add you, okay? And you, Joel Timmons, are definitely wicked cool. You're wicked awesome. And for you, the thrill is gone. June 1969. This is what blues is all about. Kick back, relax, drink a little as I give some birthday shout-outs for those for August 16th. There's a few very special friends of mine that absolutely deserve it. Oh, my God! The song itself is orgasmic. It really is, folks. Listen to that. Listen to Lucille play. Oh. August 16th birthdays. My man, Craig Schultz. Future Rail Hugging the Day on Arizona Day. Craig and Rebecca Schultz. Love you guys. You are two of my biggest fans on Arizona Day. And, originally out of Wichita, Kansas. Living in Moore, Oklahoma. Oh, yeah, more Okies out there. How about that? Craig Schultz. I know it's going to be your birthday by the time you watch this show. Craig and Becca Schultz. You folks are so inspirational. What you went through being homeless a couple of years ago to what you got going on now. I'm so proud of you both. You two are amazing people, amazing friends, and I can't wait to the day where I meet you both in person. Craig and Becca Schultz and Craig's father, Paul. Yo, Paulie. Hey, gotta have a Paulie in the mix, right? Paul Schultz follows me. They have brought friends to me. The Schultz family, love you all. Y'all, wicked awesome, and you totally rock. Craig Schultz, happy August 16th birthday to your bud. And I'm big, she's a busy, a big guy. To my good friend Jeff Bell! Not Jeff Bell! Sorry, Jeff Bell, it's not your birthday, that was July 6th. Jeff Hall! He's out of Utah! That's right! Utah! Jeff Hall! A badass crew dog that I worked with in Girl, California, Atlanta, Fruits of Death, otherwise known as Southern Oregon! Jeff Hall! Woo! Happy birthday to you! August 16th, Jeff Hall. Yeah, brother. What you gonna do, brother? When I hit you in the eye with a woman's shoe, size 7. Ah! Dude, I miss watching wrestling with you and I, good buddy Jeff Kirkpatrick. The two Jeffs and I would watch wrestling together all the time. Jeff Kirkpatrick had his birthday 2 days ago. Well, Jeff Hall's birthday is August 16th. Jeff, happy birthday, motherfucker. And as you are. Because every time you fuck a mom, you're a motherfucker, right? Yeah. I'm gonna wake up on some day, buddy. Celebrate while I enjoy it. I'll burn through the beers. And Jeff Hall, go ahead and say it. Who's your pappy? That's right. And of course, Jeff Hall, you know this. And I know this. And we love our dear buddy Jerome Isom. Jerome Isom is a big time Wicked Hardcore San Francisco 49ers fan. He's a California native and legend and icon. Of course, California is otherwise known as Western Nevada. Jerome Isom is such a cool cat and a great man. A compliment out with a walking brain of a man. And Jerome Isom and Jeff Hall were born the exact same month and year. If that ain't wicked awesome, I don't know what is. Jerome was originally born in Quezon City, Philippines. And ironically enough, I have a license plate from the year that him and I were born. Hell yeah! From Quezon City, and I've showed you that plate. If I get another Philippines license plate from 1973, Jerome, I'm gonna give you that one. Because you're from Quezon City, Philippines originally. And, brother, like you and I and Jeff. Yeah, Jeff Paul. We all serve Mount Lord and I can prove it. It was wicked awesome. Jeff Bell served U.S. Army. Yeah. And thank you all for your service and sacrifice out there watching. Because without you, we'd all be worthless as tits on a board. Yep. Freedom isn't free, and so many people have made the ultimate sacrifice. And hats off to all those who have. Absolutely. Wow, the thrill is gone. What a song that is. Man, we're already at the 1 hour and 1 minute mark, and I haven't even gotten to the eye candy yet. Oh, boy. And I have 595 pictures of our baby today. Holy shit. Wow. All right. Did I make it through all the birthday shout-outs? Yes, I did. Did I make it through all the additional shout-outs? Not yet. So what I'm going to do before I get to our vehicle instrument bet of the day is we're going to tell that woman. We're going to play Tell That Woman. The Big Three Trio, Willie Dixon, of course, the legendary blues songwriter, Willie Dixon, D-I-X-O-N. He wrote songs for Bo Diddley, Howlin' Wolf, Muddy Waters, a lot of Chess Records artists. Willie Dixon was one of the greatest blues songwriters of all time. And he was also a fantastic bluesman as well. A big bass voice and a phenomenal big bass player. And this guy, a big man, floating around the 300-pound mark. Believe me, he was big enough to play the big bass. And listen to him as he leads the crew, along with Leonard, Baby Duke Caston, and Ollie Crawford. Tell That Woman, May 29th, 1951, as I give some quick additional shout-outs as we play this song. Yeah. You're going to love this. The Big Three Trio. Tell That Woman, listen to that piano, will ya? Yeah. And listen to the big bass voice of Willie Dixon.
I went up the river to make some sense. I thought I'd bring some money back.
Born July 1st, 1915. Passed away at the age of 76 in January 1992.
Somebody tell that woman.
I love the Big Three Trio. I love Willie Dixon.
Somebody tell that
Willie Dixon was a great bluesman. Vastly underrated, folks.
Big boat up the river on a bank of sand that she don't hit deep water, she won't never
I want to give a shout out to my dear friend Jeremy McNally.
Me for some other
he
man,
has multiple men in one body. Because Jeremy McNally, you brother, you bring it and bring it with your hot quiet every fucking day, dude. Yeah, you do.
And she won't come down.
We can't do it without you, Jeremy McNally. I want you to know I appreciate what you do so much on the job site every motherfucking day of the week. Jeremy McNally, a legend, an icon, a badass, and I'll drink to that. And a gorgeous couple. I love these ladies big time.
People turning round and round.
No wonder we got something today. Fucking A today. Comprised at 690. Always on the go. And her lovely gorgeous equal half. Stephanie Flores. Steph! You two lovely goddesses. The pineapple princesses of awesomeness. Today is Steph. You two lovely ladies, I'm telling you, you two made the job site a much better place. Thank you so much for doing what you do.
When I get home,
and Steph and Danae, I know you lovely elderly ladies will probably get a rectus nipulus when you drool over that hotness right there. Because I know I got a rectus dickimus. Jeremy McNally, you probably have a rectus dickimus too. There's a lot of erections going on, whether male or female. Because, folks, Ruby May. Oh, my God. Oh, yeah. She can make a gay man go straight. She can make an impotent man rise to the occasion. She can make a heterosexual woman go bisexual without full-blown lesbian. Because she's hot, real hot, damn hot, red hot, or smoking hot. And she says, drink, and that we shall. Alright.
Time for our vehicle instrument pattern today on Bear Song Day. We're going to take the 1927 for this.
So I got a 1927 automobile. I got a 1927 song. November 1927 from a man who was born in 1883 or 1884 and passed away in October 15, 1979 at the ripe old age of 95, 96 years old. We're talking about Gus Cannon. Gus Cannon with his band The Jug Stompers. Gus Cannon's Jug Stompers. This song is called Poor Boy Long Ways From Home. A song that was originally done by Bo Weevil Jackson in 1926. This was the second version of the song, and many others have done it over the decades. Poor Boy Long Ways From Home. You know the song. You may or may not know this version, folks. November 1927, Gus Cannon on the banjo. And we're going to bring out our vehicle of the day. A 1927 Buick Touring Sedan. Look at that automobile, will you? 1927 Buick Touring Sedan. Ain't that nice?
Been a poor boy a long way from home.
And what are you hearing? You're hearing that instrument right now.
Long way from
Gus
home.
Cannon. Gus Cannon's
been
banjo. That picture's from approximately 1927. Maybe 1928. Gus Cannon. You're hearing him right now. And this picture from 1971. He was still touring and still performing. By then, he was already in his upper 80s, okay? He lived a good, long life. Gus Cannon's banjo. That's your instrument of the day on Barrett's on Day. Fuckin' A.
But I guess I have to get that
bitch. Time for our pet of the day.
Man, if that don't do him why.
And our pet of the day comes from our baby today, Ruby May. Her dog, Pekoe. P-E-K-O-E. Pekoe. I hope I pronounced that right.
I cried, yo.
Make your dog a lucky dog today. It's a lucky dog right there. I haven't decided if I'm going to use that picture or that picture. I know, I might get banned on Facebook and YouTube for full frontal nudity of a dog. But she's in her bra and panties and I fucking love that.
I cried, sweet ma'am, give me 13.49.
And of course, her previous dog she had, and she's in her bra and panties, and said, hey, let's drink. I love it.
I cried, sweet ma'am,
oh, Ruby May, you're so fat.
Back to four and two.
And this guy right here, there's a lot of you out there that love the Jonas Brothers. I can give a fucking frog's fat ass about the fucking Jonas Brothers, okay? I'm not into that modern boy band fuckface shit, okay? But that's me! Just because I don't like something doesn't mean you should. Because folks, this is the United States of America. And we have the freedom to think differently. And thank God we have that freedom. And a lot of people out there are trying to get rid of that freedom. Because they want us to all think the same. And I say, Fuck you! No! Have the freedom to think differently. Embrace it. Learn it. Live it. Love it. Thank God for New York Yankees fans. Gives me somebody to make fun of anyway. I'm a Red Sox fan. But I would be bored if I didn't have any New York Yankees fans out there, okay? Thank God for those that think differently politically, religiously, different sports teams. You know, all I ask from all of you is that you respect each other's opinions and you always stay positive.
Yup.
That's important. Hey! You know, some people don't even like it when people are gay. I say, fuck it, hey, what's wrong with that? If two people are happy, what's the problem? If it's against the Bible, let God be the ultimate judge, jury, and execution. Not you and not me. I support same-sex marriages. I support Republicans. I support Democrats. I support equality. I fucking hate racism. What I do want is for everybody to love each other regardless of what affiliation you are, okay? That's all I ask. That's all I want. That's love. Look at that. Joe Jonas is a milestone 30 years old today. He is your hunk of the day on Bears on Day. Look at that goddess Charlotte McKinney. I think I have featured her in the past on Bears on a Day, actually. I'll have to double check. All right. Well, here's a song I have never played before. I don't think I have. The song is called Going Out by Sylvester Mike from July 14th, 1948. Oh, this is great. And there's your hug of the day. I apologize for the lighting. My lighting is not good. But I'm gonna do the best I can, okay? Sylvester Mike, July 14th, 1948. Joe Jonas is 30 years old today. Awesome! There you go, ladies, and you men that love the man.
I'm looking for love and gold.
Carlos Peña Vega, actor, is also 30 years old today. Very cool. How about Jennifer Lawrence? Jennifer Lawrence, oh my God, she's so fucking hot. She's 29 and mighty fine. She's a former Bear of the Day on Bears on Day. Rapper Nipsey Hussle. Born in the state in 1985, tragically murdered at the age of 33 years old earlier this year in 2019. Sad but true. Nipsey Hussle. Oh, there's Joe Jonas when he was young. His brother. Joe Jonas with the red shirt, Coca-Cola, hell yeah. Coke's a lot better than Pepsi, folks, in my opinion. I'm a Coke drinker, not a Pepsi drinker, okay?
I'm not by myself. I'm on my love and soul, and I need nobody else.
Joe Jonas. Y'all are going to stay all the Arizona day. Turn it
in. I think I'll settle down.
Yeah, again, I apologize for the lady. America, let her hurry home to pray, motherfucker.
I found what I'm looking for.
Napoleon Bonaparte. That piece of shit dictator, Napoleon Bonaparte, born in the state of 1769 and passed away at the age of 51 in St. Helena at the age of 51. Napoleon Bonaparte, a dictator, probably more of a dictator, honestly, little prick. Aye! We're going to dial it way back to March 1925. The song is called Rock, Aunt Dinah Rock. Coop Grant and Kid Wilson. These guys, this duo did a lot of great songs during the 1920s and early 1930s, and even did some very sexual innuendo songs. Well, this one is one of their earlier entries, Coot Grant, Sox Wilson. Rock Aunt Dinah Rock. Joe Jonas, 30 years old today. This song's nearly 94 and a half years old. Wow. There are no ladies in the middle of the night. He's topless. Hey, a man can be topless when he's real, be topless too. Again, I support equality. Facebook doesn't, I know that. I like that hat. Very nice. Very nice hat right there. I don't know who that hot chick is, but she is hot. Joe Jonas. 30 years old today, kids. That chick's from South Korea. She's a guitarist. Jin Lu, I think her name is. She's a cutie. Yeah. And she says, smoke them if you got them. I will later. But I'll drink to that. Legendary U.S. volleyball player, beach volleyball, Kerry Walsh Jennings. Kerry Walsh Jennings, 41 years old today. Gold medal winning beach volleyball legend with Missy May trainer. Awesome stuff. Actress Deborah Messing of Will and Grace is 51 years old today. The late, great, legendary gourmet chef. The French chef. Julia Child. Julia Child. Consider her a pioneer of cooking shows on TV. Julia Child. The French chef, gourmet chef, born to say 1912, passed away at the ripe old age of 91 years old in 2004. Julia Child was something else. And I always loved how she was always throwing her pans around and stuff like that. She did not fuck around. Actress Rosemarie of the Dick Van Dyke Show. Rosemarie lived a good long life and she was hilarious. She was born in the state in 1923, passed away at the ripe old age of 94 years old in 2017. Let's go ahead and slam this one home real quick. After this, the brain cells of an average New York Jets fan. I got six more pictures, and I'm going to bring out our next song and our baby of the day, and I'm going to finish it off showing as many pictures as I can, but it's already 7:40 p.m., and I've got to get to bed. Joe Jonas. There you go. Your hunk of the day on Baron's Song of the Day. Fergin' A. I know he's a knockout, right, ladies? And you men that love the men? Yeah. Sure. Of course, in my opinion, all men are ugly, disgusting, and repulsive. And I'm a lesbian trapped in a man's body. So there. Yeah, now we're talking. Now that is a woman that will make my meat whistle rise to the occasion. Yeah, baby. All right. We have shown off your hunk of the day. The rest of the music for the day and the eye candy will be our baby of the day. I got three more songs that I have slated for today's show. And if we're going to bring out a hot baby today, we better bring out a hot beer. And what better than the legendary, wicked, awesome Pappy Slocum Brewing Company's Stripper Dust. That's right. Stripper Dust. Because, see, It's at 409 South Trade right here in Abilene, yeah, Texas. Come to the brewery this Saturday between 11 a.m. and 7 p.m. Yeehaw, Texas time. Well, get there before 6:30 p.m. because last call will be about 6:40, okay? So for the love of God, get yourself some stripper dust or go to some adult beverage stores and buy some. Vile Liquors always has it. Vile Liquors, best adult beverage store around. 4301 Rio Mesa Drive here in Abilene, yeah, Texas, on the corner of Buffalo Gap Road. Military veteran, owner, and operator, we love you, Philo Liquors. You're totally wicked awesome. And it's the right thing to do. Proverbs and Empires, proper technique, here we go. Final beer of the day on Baron Song Day, 6.7% alcohol by volume. 45 grand, right? Based on Zap Ass, however, keyboard comes that damn good. I was going to drop you that damn it will. The rest of the songs for today, we're going to show off our baby today on Baron Song Day and Brian Kokenauer. I know you like me. You know, we like to put some meat on them bones. And hey, I'll tell you, bro, I got a lot of pictures taken with me. Oh, fuck it. I'll go ahead and do it anyway. Let's take a picture with Pappy Southern Brewing Company. Stripper dust. Let's do it. Just like Nike. Just do it. Even though those cocksuckers support Colin Kaepernick, prick. That fucking communist cocksucker. He supports communism. What a fuckface cocksucker motherfucker. I can't stand Colin Kaepernick, prick. Fuck him with a big wooden dick so he gets splinters. Not too shabby, eh? Not bad for an ugly looking motherfucker, huh? Yeah. Well, that's a wicked awesome beer. Stripper dust. I love ya. Aye. To the baby of the day. And to our next song. It is all baby of the day from here. And warning. Again, if you have sensitive eyes, now is not the time to watch because there will be some bare female boobies because she's got huge motherfucking jugs. And I'll drink to that. Cheers and beers to all you pros in Germany, by St. Japan. This is a 5-star beer. Hey, you owners of Pappy Soka may not like the beer, but I fucking love it. Jeff, Brian, a.k.a. Coke, and Richie, how can you guys not like stripper dust? I don't get it. Because you guys have great taste in beer. You guys are awesome at what you do. But damn, stripper dust. Dude, it's amazing. All right, speaking of amazing, how about Brutal Hearted Woman? Johnny Shines, January 22nd, 1953. Ah, what a good one. And I just realized I skipped over some songs. We got more than just 3 songs left. On her knees for me.
And I'm so tired of crying.
And yes, those are maroon panties, my favorite color. Ladies, if you're watching, send me a matching group. Send me a picture of a of you wearing the maroon matching burn panty set. And I will show it off on my show, okay?
I'll get into that.
Check out Shiver Waste Business. Of course. Oh. I'm recording a lot. lot later than I wanted to.
Good morning!
If it's morning for you. Hell, I'll drink to that. Some songs. Well, we might need a little churching up, so we're gonna do that real quick. When I Lay My Burden Down, October 11th, 1929. Reverend Edward W. Claiborne. Great song, great guitar, Hawaiian style guitar. You're gonna love this. When I Lay My Burden Down. Reverend Edward W. Claiborne. Hallelujah!
When I lay,
I say hallelujah when I see her beer boobies. I love God's hard work.
Glory, oh,
hallelujah!
When I lay my burden down.
Oh my God.
Polka dots!
Our next song, more church music from his last recording session, April 20th, 1930. Blind Willie Johnson with his wife Angelique on the vocals as well. Church, I'm Fully Saved Today. I love this song. Listen to him use his guitar as percussion.
Saved today.
Listen to the lyrics and enjoy the eye candy.
The night away. Ain't no evil can be done. I'm only by myself. Church, I'm fully saved today. And I'm in the way.
Ain't no
evil
can be done.
I'm walking by myself. I am one.
That was him slapping the side of his guitar. Amazing. Oh my
God. I'm walking and alive.
Oh my God.
Church, I'm pulling.
I'm saved now, motherfuckers. Why, hallelujah. Amen. Klein didn't put his name on her. Fuck that. Lucky prick. Jesus. Aye. That was a great song. All right. John Peterson, you don't know this song. This song's called Mosu Teke Soma Ye. M-O-U-S-O-T-E-K-E Soma S-O-M-A and a Ye Y-E. Mosu Teke Soma Ye. From March 1996. By a man named Boubacar, and no Stephanie Flores, not to be confused with Boubacar, our good buddy, FedEx guy, a dear friend. But this is Boubacar Traore. Traore. T-R-A-O-R-E. Traore. Boubacar Traore. He is 77 years old. He is still going strong. He's still touring and performing. He is basically number two in Mali, Africa, to Ali Faka Touré, as far as Mali blues legends. And there you go, John Peterson. A little knowledge for you, buddy. From March 1996. Awesome song. Kick back, relax, enjoy the eye candy. African music, you may not know what he's singing, but it don't matter. Because that's a language of love right there. Let's all drink. got 595 pictures of her. And there she is at an Aussie Rules football game. AFL Aussie Rules football. That is on my bucket list. I want to go to one of those games so bad. It's like rugby on speed. That was our first 100 pictures of her, okay? Red, white, and blue. Yeah. Aussie Rules football, that is so cute and hot. And her bonds panties. Creamy meatballs. Yeah. Oh. Shower titties. Yeah. With glasses. Kick asses. Heavy haggis. Hey, you gotta feed them jugs. You gotta feed them titties. Keep nice and big and beefy. Hey, she's changed her own tire for you. I love that. That's so sexy. When a woman's doing mechanical work, I do find that sexy. I'm really feeling that. Wow. Happy 83rd birthday to Pat Priest! Who remembers the TV show The Munsters? Pat Priest was Marilyn Munster, the daughter, in the TV show The Munsters that ran from 1963 to 1966. Yeah. Bobby Helms. Bobby Helms, famous from the 1957 classic song. Drawing a blank. My Special Angel. And, Jingle Bell Rock. Bobby Helms sang Jingle Bell Rock and My Special Angel. Both stories in 1957. Bobby Helms was born in 1933. Sadly passed away at the age of 63 in 1997. Get the drink on, and she's wet on her boobies, and wet beaver too. Wet ball beaver. Bobby Bird, part of James Brown. In fact, he's the one who discovered James Brown. Bobby Bird, legendary folk soul musician, born in 1934, passed away in 1973. In 2007, oh my gosh, she's a good Jim Dale, phenomenal actor and comedian Jim Dale, out of Joyeux, England, 84 years old today. Jim Dale, I've been watching him in the 1977 movie Pete's Dragon that my sister Crystal wore out on the VHS.
from the VCR, okay? Pinch Dragon from 1977, great movie. And Jim Dale was the villain, but he was hilarious. That's an awesome movie. I love that movie. I really do. Actress Natasha Henstridge, 45 years old today. Yeah. And there's nudies out there of her from the late 1990s. I know because I used to look at them. Yeah. Great song from Mali, Africa. Oh my God. Yeah. Hi. So our next song. This song was recorded the year, 1 year to the day that my grandparents got married. My grandparents got married October 23rd, 1940. Sadly, my grandfather, 12th Army Division, passed away February 4th, 2013. At the ripe old age of 93 years old. My grandmother, my grandmother Betty, she passed away 75 days later at the age of 90. That was true love right there. Seven kids, 20 grandchildren, 32 great-grandchildren, and 5 great-great-grandchildren. This song was recorded on their one-year wedding anniversary by Buddy Moss. The song is called I'm Sitting Here Tonight. Buddy Moss, and we've got Brownie McGee on here as well, along with Sonny Terry on the harmonica, one of the greatest heart blowers of all time. Here you go. I got this song and two others left, and then I'm going to go. Okay? I'm Sitting Here Tonight, October 23rd, 1941. If it pulls up. Uh-oh. There it is. And you got O-Red on the washboard. Not washboard same, but O-Red. O-Red on the washboard. Sonny Terry blowing harp. Buddy Moss on the vocals and guitar, and Brownie McGee on guitar as well. Wow, what a song this is.
Come on, baby, move over. I'm sitting here tonight. Come on, baby, move over.
Oh, happy Halloween. Yeah. Wow, pretty pink.
Say what you will, baby. Do what you think. I'll be here till the break of day. Come on, baby, move over.
Princess Anne, the daughter of Queen Elizabeth II, the sister of Prince Charles. Princess Anne, 69 years old, awesome. Natasha Bure, the daughter of Valerie Bure and Candace Cameron Bure. I grew up watching and drooling over Candace Cameron in Full House, okay? Candace Cameron is hot, and now her daughter, Natasha Bure, is hot. Her daughter's 21 years old and born this day in 1998. God bless, I feel fucking old. Actor Ben Affleck, born in California, raised in Massachusetts. In fact, his brother Casey was born in Falmouth, Massachusetts, the same town that I was born in. It's a small world. Ben Affleck is 47 years old today. Fuck yeah! I almost had him as hooking a day on my show. Funbags. Yeah. I'll get that later, actually. Ah! Oh, my God. Fuck me running. Good Lord. Two more songs. Let's play My Little Cupid Doll. April 1954. Sam Lightning Hopkins. Lightning Hopkins. Here you go. April 1955. Hey, guys, you want to put this shout out? I'm not going to show all 595 pictures of them, okay? But if you want them, I'll show them to you already.
No.
Two more songs and I'm gone, kids.
Work with me, I'll work with you.
I would work her over to a house.
Get on the phone, you'll know exactly what to do.
Oh, yeah.
Woman.
Woman.
Tell me what's wrong with you.
What's wrong with her? She's not in my arms.
Whoa.
Woman.
Whoa, what's
wrong?
You acting so funny now. Don't know what to do.
Tess! Lingerie! I'll drink to that. Let's drink. Let's not get tired with you. Oh my fucking God.
That's what I'm talking about.
That's what I'm talking about.
Hi, baby. You my little Cupid doll, old man.
Hey, you don't know about the tennis, though.
My little Cupid doll,
old man.
Yes, you my little
Cupid.
God knows I don't mean me.
Fuck. Oh, Peter. Oh, fuck. So, I gotta find where I left off. I found where I left off. Yeah. I left off on some tennis! Alright. Maybe this won't be the last song, because I think I need to play something dirty after this one. Country Blues, August 1941, recorded at Stovall's Plantation. John Allen Lomax, looking for music. And they went to Stovall's Plantation in Mississippi. And found the young man by the name of McKinley Morganfield. We know him today as Muddy Waters. Muddy Waters, born April 2nd, 1913. Many years they said he was born 1915. Now they say 1913. He passed away April 30th, 1983 of heart attack, cardiac arrest, in his sleep at the age of 68 or 70 years old. Muddy Waters, one of the greatest bluesmen of all time. My personal favorite bluesman. This was the first song he ever recorded. Well, this is the first song that was ever recorded, I should say. He'd probably been playing even before then. The man that they say went to Chicago and invented electricity. And anybody who's ever seen the movie, of course, I'm going to draw a blank on it now. Fuck. Ralph Macchio. Joe Seneca. Jamie Gertz. Steve Vai, drawing a blank on the name of the movie now, from 1986. But yeah, I have the movie, and yeah, they said Muddy Waters invented electricity. Well, Muddy Waters wasn't afraid of modern progress, and when he went to Chicago in 1947, he definitely made an impact. And Country Blues, Muddy Waters, August 1941. Here you go. Yeah! Take me to the country. That's fucking the haystacks.
moving anytime I feel it. Like blowing my horn.
I got a horn, she can blow. We'll drink together on that.
My little baby gone. Later in the evening, man, man. I feel like blowing my horn.
Feel like going home. He lived in a song called
I feel like going home.
April 1948. Greater panties. Cause it says, fuck you, pay me.
Well now.
Hey!
Some folks said it worthy.
You pay the fuck
you
anyway.
Bad.
Why not pay the woman?
That's the merest feeling, child, I most ever had. Some folks tell me.
I'll drink to that. You know what, I'm going to go ahead and call it a day after this show. Because I'm getting tired. You've seen plenty of titties. If you want more titties, private message me and tell me you want to see more titties.
If I don't find my baby, somebody gonna bury me.
And again,
went to the ocean.
Oh, Beaver! This is gonna be my final song of the day, our bear song of the day, okay?
Don't find
she can lay lick her titties, and I love it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I got something you can pump, sweetheart.
Things like this.
Oh, yeah.
Seems like my baby will stop up. Oh, Lord, I'm ready. When it seems like I was tired, and I was seems like this.
Final song of the day, on Bear Song of the Day, yeah.
Yeah, seems like my wife.
I got another three other pictures that I will show on a future show. We're going to have her as our baby today and get it down the road, okay? But I got to go after this. I got to. Irish and good. Give me some motherfucking head. Yeah. Pretty and pink. Hope to God she don't stink. That's right, this is Sydney, Australia. Listen to that fierce guitar and drink it. We love you, Ruby May.
I'm leaving this morning if I had a
drink and slam it.
We'll ride the blind. I feel Miss City Girl, you know now. I don't mind living in Morgan.
I didn't even make it through half the pictures. That's 264.
Yeah.
Out of 5.
In Miss City, baby,
okay. Oh, you don't believe
I don't
me?
Don't mind dying.
Look at this. Oh, you can't see it. Shit. Yeah, it's getting too dark in here, so look at that. Picture 595. Man alive. Folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, remember Dr. B. Folks, it's time to make the fetus and head out. So everybody take care. Have an awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I'm going to do. Don't drink and drive. You might spray and drink. I might kill yourself or somebody else and drink it and drive. It's dumb than being a Yankees fan. And what's dumb than that is being a fan of Justine. Ow. I should have swallowed because such a little bitch bag, 12 off a waste of a sperm egg. No shit, you eye little bitch. Beaver. And you know what? She probably has one of those too, just saying. But you know what? Something that, though, is men slap women, or animal abuse, or racism, or people watch on bets, or fake friends, or anybody that supports friends, or is any member of the Westboro Baptist Church, or ISIS, or the Facebook police, or fucking rats out there who try to bring down awesomeness. Yeah, fuck ya. Things like that are just plain stupid. And definitely deserve a big fret. Wop out. GFY. Right up there. Rudy Poe Carnass. Folks, I'm out of here. I haven't done a Sacred Sunday show in a long time. I really want to do one on Sunday. So my goal is to have that be my next show. A little gospel music, Christian music, and some eye candy. I think it's the right thing to do. I will see you all. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye! Bye! And I hope to God my show's not fucked over. We shall see. Mm-hmm.